Hello all dear students, we have in the last class discussed about the concepts regarding arrays. Please let me know if my voice is audible. Okay, so you can message through the chat box, right? Is my voice audible? Yes. Okay. So in the previous class we discussed about arrays, some concepts regarding operations on the array, that is lab sheet 3. So this lab sheet is available to you on EDH as well as in the group. I hope you have gone through the problems we discussed. Okay, so you execute them as well, right? So we discussed, just to revise, the first problem was based on one dimensional array in which we have just simple input and output of the array elements, right? So that is, Mr. Ashish purchases 10 items from the shop, so he has to maintain the list. So he is storing the price list of those 10 elements in an array, and the problem is just input and output of the array elements. So we have seen this problem wherein we have declared an array of size 10. Next part, we have taken input for the array elements and then we are printing the array elements. So this is basic input output of array elements, right? So next we discussed problem 2, which has some operations on the elements of the array. So here, as a continuation, he has stored the item price. So Mr. Ashish now has to pay the bill. So he wants to know the total price, how much has to be paid in the bill. So that was the second question, wherein we have the 10 prices stored in the array. So these have to be added so that we know the total bill amount. So here we have added one item of the array to another one by one. So starting from zero, the first part remains declaration and the input of the array remains the same. Next we have the sum of the array elements. We find the sum of each array elements, add one by one, and then find the total sum. So that is the bill amount, right? So next we have discussed about problem 3, so which is just to modify a set of statement, set of values in the array. So here we are going to change the odd index elements to 0. So when we consider this, we are going to check the element index, right? So if the index is odd number, for example 1, 3, 5, 7 and 9, right? So here index are odd numbers, so these are not available in the market, so we need not pay for it. So it has to be changed to 0, right? So all the odd array index elements have to be changed to 0. So here we can check for the array index. If it is odd, then change the item value to 0. So we have seen two different types of implementation for this, right? So in the problem, so one way is with a for loop. In this first part, again remains the same, right? Taking input for the array elements after declaration. In next for loop, we see that the array index is checked. If it is odd, then make the item to 0. So I is the index, I percentage 2 will be equal to 0 if it is even. So if it is not equal to 0, it is odd. So we check I percentage 2 not equal to 0. So that means if it is odd, make that item value as 0. So this is the implementation, and then we just print all the array elements, right? Next part. Now this part can also be implemented in another way, right? So we saw another way, because we know that index, whichever starts from 1 and so on up to the end. So even numbers have same, but odd numbers have to be changed to 0. So that code can also be replaced by this one, right? Starting from 1, increment I every time by 2, so that we get 1 plus 2, 3 plus 2, 5 plus 2, 7 and so on till 10, right? So here each value with the index as 1, 3, 5, 7, 9 has to be made as 0. So this for loop can be implemented in this way also. And next, we have the problem 4 wherein we have to check for a particular price. So we have taken input for the array and then we take input for a particular price. In problem 4, we need to check that based on the set of items, check with this particular price, which are the elements less than this price. So we discussed with the example, so wherein we took like 50, for example, is the price. Display all the values which are less than 50. So here from the beginning of the array, we need to check. So that is why we have used one for loop, right? So in this, from the beginning, check for each item of the array. So item of 0, is it less than price? If it is true, print it, right? So every item which is less than 50 has to be printed. This continues till the last number. So till 10 we are checking. So 0 to 9 will be the index for the array of size 10. So among those, whichever value is less than price will be displayed. So these were the 4 programs we had discussed until previous class. And then these are only some of the modifications or operations we can do on the array, like arithmetic or relational operator, using them like comparing each array element to some other element like this here price, or comparing each array element to each other, less than, greater than, and so on. We may perform any kind of operation. And then we have basically 2 important types of operations which we can perform. That is searching and sorting, right? What is searching? So like the name itself says, we are searching. So in this case, we are searching for an element in the array. We have a list of array elements. Among them, we are searching for a particular number. So for this, I had shared a video. So previously last week. So I hope you have watched that. So which is using linear search. So searching is a process to identify whether the element is present in the given array or not, right? In that, in detail, I have explained using one example, right? So, and then tracing, program, flowchart, and execution also. So let us just have a gist, so an overview. So here, there are different techniques for searching. So one among them is linear search. And then we may have binary search and so on. There are many searching techniques. They are also called as algorithms, right? So linear searching is one of them. So today we have linear search and then we will discuss sorting also, right? What is linear search? It is a searching wherein sequentially we check the elements of the array. So we have one key element to be checked. So if that key element is there present in the array, we say that the search is successful. If it is not there in the array, if the element is not found in the array, we say that the search is unsuccessful. So here, why is it called linear search? Because in a linear order, we are going to check. Consider an example here. The same I have considered there as well. So that we have an array of size 5. All are integers, so they are nothing but 10, 15, 1, 3, 20. These are the values in the array. So they are represented by the index. ARR of 0 is the first number, 10. Similarly, ARR of 1 is 15, and then we have the rest till ARR of 4. Now, if we have to search, let us assume the key element is 3. If we just see manually, we can see that 3 is there in the array. That means element is found. This linear search is also called as sequential search because sequentially or in an order, we are searching for the element. So we start from the first element and then search in order one by one. So in a linear order. So in the same order, we are going to search. Now 3 will be first compared to 10, which is the first number. Since they are not equal, now 3 will be compared to 15. 15 also is not equal to 3. 3 is compared to 1. 1 is also not equal to 3. Now 3 is compared to 3. Since they are equal, we say that the element is found in the array. In case this was 30, so it will be compared one by one. And when we see this till the end, 30 is not there. So we say that the search is unsuccessful, right? So this was the concept discussed. And then we had the problem wherein Suhas wants to know if he is selected for an audition. So 10 students were selected and Suhas number had to be searched. So we have to search using linear search and find out if Suhas is selected for the audition. So this problem itself I had explained there. So we are taking input for the array number and then take input for Suhas number, which is the key element. Now we are comparing each element of the array starting from zero. Number of zero is the first number. Compare it with Suhas number. If they are equal, we change flag to one and break. If all the array elements are checked, still none of the element matches with Suhas number, that means he is not selected for the audition, right? So flag remains as zero. So this is the main logic, so which we discussed right there. So with example also. So now if any case, any number has matched with Suhas number, flag has changed to one. So if flag has changed to one, that means Suhas is selected for the music club. Now this percentage D is nothing but the place value, because array starts from zero. So we saw that Suhas was selected in say fifth place. So it will be number of four. I value was four. So he will be selected in fifth place. If in case his number is not there, flag is not at all changed to one. So it remains zero. So control, this condition becomes false and control comes to else part and we print Suhas is not selected for the club. So till here we have seen. Now please let me know if there are any doubts. Are there any doubts till this? Is this concept clear? All of you are unmuted anyway, so you can please let me know your doubt. So you have chat box enabled as well as you can and ask your doubts also. All of you are unmuted. Anyway, please let me know your doubt.
Harshraj?
Hare Krishna. Okay, no doubts? Yeah. What about Hare Krishna? All of you, please lower audio behind. Hare Krishna is here. Let me know if you have any doubts. So you have the chat box enabled. So in case you have any doubts, you can message there as well, or you have the option of unmuting yourself also. You can unmute and use the option to ask the doubt. Okay, so here we have one. So in this case, we have used a flag equal to one. So that is because if we have changed the number, the value of flag, right? So why? So we have a doubt. Why is this condition checked? So flag equal to one is checked because in case the number is found in any of the array, right? Any of the array position. So one of them matches with Suha's number, then only we will change flag to one. Otherwise, flag remains with the initial value of zero. So flag will be changed only if it is found. So that becomes a help for us to know if it is found. Otherwise, flag is zero only. So that is the reason we check flag equal to one. And equal to is because it is a comparison operator. So if we give single equal to, what happens? It is assignment operator. So flag gets equal to one and always we will get the same message, right? So we have to give double equal to for comparison. I hope this doubt is now clear, right? So because we are comparing the value of flag to one, we have to use double equal to. Okay. Yeah. Fine. So we will continue, right? So please go through the videos again, right? So this example with full tracing and the problem flowchart execution, everything is there in the video. I want you all to watch that video. Okay. Right. So now let us see, one of them is searching, another operation very important, one is searching and next one is sorting. What is the meaning of sorting? Sorting is like arranging the elements, or say we are going to give an order for the elements. How are they going to be arranged? Sorting is a technique of arranging the elements. So it can be arranged in either ascending order or descending order. So ascending order means smallest first and then continue till the largest. And descending is the exact opposite. Largest first and then arrange with the smaller ones, right? So there are many sorting techniques like bubble sort, selection sort, quick sort, merge sort, insertion sort, heap sort, and so on, which you will be coming across in your further semesters. So in this today's topic, we will be discussing about bubble sort. Okay, so today we will see how to sort the elements of the array. So when we give input, it may not always be like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, right? We may give elements in any order. So in that case, say we want to sort them in ascending order. So let us consider first ascending order and then we will see how to do sorting for descending, right? So what is this bubble sort? It is a technique to sort the elements of the array. So what is the logic behind this? Let us see the logic with the help of one example. Okay, so here consider this bubble sort. We have taken four elements in an array. I hope this is clearly visible. Yes, I hope this screen is clearly visible. Please let me know if there is any problem. Right, so here we have taken four elements of the array. Assume that they are 10, 1, 5 and 2. Now we are going to sort this in ascending order. So what is the expected output? So the smallest number has to come first. Smallest among these is 1. Next smallest next number will be 2, larger than that. Next number has to be 5 and then we should have 10. So the array should be arranged like 1, 2, 5, 10. That is the meaning of sorting. Now how to sort this? So we have the technique of bubble sort, like the name says. So if we keep a container, so all the larger numbers will settle down, larger bubbles settle down, smaller bubbles are on top. So we are going to bring the smaller numbers on top, right? Similar to bubbles, right? So here we are going to compare the numbers, two numbers at a time, right? Let me see. First, we have the first pass. As we have seen in previous examples, say pattern. So if for each value of I, so I equal to 0 will be pass 1, I equal to 1 is pass 2, I equal to 2 will be pass 3 and so on, we continue, right? So here also we have the first pass I equal to 0. Now, according to this, there are n min- minus I minus 1 comparisons. That means so many times we will compare the different elements of the array. N is the number of elements in the array. So that means we have 1, 2, 3, 4. N value for this example is 4. 4 minus, in the first pass, I is 0. I starts from 0. So 4 minus 0 minus 1. So that is, in the first pass, there will be 3 comparisons. Do not worry about the steps. I will tell you one by one. Right? This is just the first pass. The number of comparisons is 4 minus 0 minus 1, that is 3. So in the first pass, there will be 3 comparisons. Let us see how, right? So now, first we have the array, we have given input like this, 10, 1, 5, 2. So we are going to compare only two numbers at a time. So that is, we will compare the first number with the second number. Compare is 10 smaller than 1. Because if 10 is in the first place, it has to be the smallest. If not, it has to move, right? So now when we compare, is 10 less than 1 condition? So in this case, 10 is not less. So it is greater than 1. So in case 10 is greater, it has to move, right? So now when we compare, yes, 10 is greater than 1. So swap them. So when we swap them, 1 comes here and 10 comes here. So that is what you can see in the second step. This is still pass 1 only. So now 1 has moved to the first position, 10 has come here. Now we compare second and third digit, second and third number. So 10 has come here, third one is 5. Note that these remain the same until we swap. So now when we compare, is 10 greater than 5? If it is greater, then it has to move, right? So move to the right. So now 10 is greater than 5. Yes. So now swap 10 and 5. So 5 has to come to second position. 10 has to move to the third position, right? 5 is in second position. 10 has come to third position. So we have compared 1, 2 times in the first pass. Now compare the third and fourth digit. Now 10 has come here. Right? So third digit is 10 now. Compare 10 with 2. Is 10 greater than 2? Yes, 10 is greater than 2. It has to move to the right. Yes, 10 is greater than 2. Swap 10 and 2. So we get 1, 5, 2 and 10. Right? 1, 5, 2 and 10. So there are 3 comparisons in the first pass. I hope the first pass is clear. Right? So now we have 1, 5, 2, 10. So now I becomes 1 in the second pass. After comparing this, I becomes 1. So number of comparisons we have to calculate every time so that we know how many times to do this. Right? So when we observe this, the largest number is in its position. Yes? Right? So the 10 is the largest number. It has come to this position. We will not touch it. We will only check for the other numbers because no use of comparing again because the largest number has already come to its position, right? So now we are comparing only these three and checking if it is in order. So how many comparisons? We have n is 4, number of elements. I in the second pass has incremented to 1. So 4 minus 1 minus 1. 4 minus 1, 3 minus 1, 2. So there are 2 comparisons in second pass. Now again we will start. So we have in the second pass the array has become 1, 5, 2, 10. So let us start the second pass. Again we will compare first and second number. So when we compare this, is 1 greater than 5? No. 1 is not greater than 5. So we will not swap. Right? Only if the first number is greater than second number, it has to move. Now 1 is not greater than 5. So there is no swapping. Now next, this is one comparison. Now second number has to be compared with third number. Second number is 5. 5, is it greater than 2? Is it greater? Yes, we see that 5 is greater than 2. So in this case, 5 has to be swapped with 2. So when we swap this, we get 1, 2, 5, 10. Right? So 1, 2, 5, 10 is sent to the third pass. Now third pass, I increments to 2. How many comparisons? N is 4, I is 2. 4 minus 2 minus 1 is 1. Now, when we observe 5 has already come here, so the last two numbers are in place. 10 came to its original place in pass 1. In second pass, 5, the next largest number, is in place. Now, we have to compare the first and second number, 1 and 2. Is 1 greater than 2? No, 1 is not greater than 2, so we don't swap. And third pass, there is only one comparison, this one. So we have got the sorted array. 1, 2, 5, 10. Is the example clear? Or shall I explain it? Okay, let me see. I will explain it again. So let us say we have the input in this format. 4 numbers, 10, 1, 5, 2. There are different comparisons in each pass. So the first pass, I starts from 1. There will be n minus I minus 1 comparisons in each pass. Note this. This is important for us, right? So here 4 minus 0 minus 1. That is, there are 3 comparisons in the first pass. 1, 2, 3 comparisons in the first pass. Now, first we compare 10 with 1. Is 10 greater than 1? Yes, true. So we are going to swap 10 and 1. So 1 comes to the first place, 10 goes to second place. Second step in pass 1, we compare 10 and 5. 10 is greater than 5. Yes, so swap them. So 10 comes here, 5 comes here, right? In next step, third step of pass 1, we compare 10 and 2. 10 is greater than 2. Yes, 10 is greater than 2, swap them. So 10 comes here, 2 comes here. So 1, 5, 2, 10, we get that. Now that is next pass. Comparisons will be 4 minus I becomes 1 here. So 4 minus 1 minus 1, there are 2 comparisons in this second pass. How do we compare? Start with first and second, 1 and 5. Is 1 greater than 5? No, 1 is not greater than 5, so there is no swap. Next, 5 will be compared with 2. When we compare, is 5 greater than 2? Yes, 5 is greater than 2, so swap 5 and 2, right? So we get 2 here and 5 here. Then we start the third pass, 4 minus 2, I has incremented to 2. Minus 1. So 4 minus 2 minus 1, we have only one comparison in the third pass. So that is the first and second number. When we compare them, 1 is it greater than 2? No. So we don't swap. And that is the sorted array. Is this example clear? Right. So here, let us see what is the logic. Note that number of comparisons is n minus I minus 1. And how many passes? There are 3 passes. Number of pass depends on the value of n. If we have 4 elements, we will have 3 passes, right? Next pass, just I will be checked with n. So now there are 3 passes for 4 elements in an array. This thing you keep in mind, right? So n minus I minus 1. That is the number of comparisons. So as a logic, we will use I to count the number of pass and J to count the number of comparisons. So now, if it starts from 0, 0, 1, 2, and so on, so we see that I will be stopping at n minus 1. So let us see. So that condition, I starts from 0, we are starting from the first element, and then J also starts from 0. So the J is for number of comparisons. So we give n minus I minus 1. Let us trace with an example also so that this will be very clear. So J starts from 0 because array index starts from 0. We are comparing the first element and the second element in the beginning, right? So we compared 10 and 1. 10 is A of 0, 1 is A of 1. So J starts from 0, that is A of 0 is 10. Is it greater than J plus 1? J plus 1 is 1. So A of 1 is 1. So we compare, is 10 greater than 1? If it is so, then we have to swap 10 and 1. So 10 is A of J, 1 is A of J plus 1. So if 10 is greater than 1, we have to swap them. Then in general terms, if A of J is greater than A of J plus 1, swap them. How do we swap? We can swap using a temporary variable. right? So we are taking a temp variable. So this is normal swapping, how we have done in the very beginning, right? So we are swapping the two numbers, a of j and a of j plus 1. So assign j, a of j to temp, and then a of j plus 1 is assigned to j, right? Then the temp value, which had stored the first number, is assigned to a of j plus 1. So we have swapped a of j and j plus 1 using a temporary variable. And this will continue till the end of the program. Let us see one tracing also next later. So here, based on this, there is a problem, right? How to solve this? Once we see with an example, we will understand more clearly. So here, problem 6 is like this. Problem statement says, Mr. Varun was making noise in the class, so he was given the task to arrange boxes in order. Each box is placed in each room. Teacher told him to arrange in ascending order. He has to compare the size of the box and arrange them. So help Mr. Varun in the logic of sorting and generate a C application for the same. So this part says, based on the size of the box, we have to arrange in ascending order. So that means we have to sort the boxes in ascending order. So for that, we need to know how many boxes are there, right? So if we know that, that is the value of n. So that is, read the number of box, right? So that is n. Next, read the size of the boxes. Say if we compare it with this example, so it may be like size of first box is 10 centimeter, then 1 centimeter, 5 centimeter, 2 centimeter. So these are the boxes and he has to arrange them. So first keep 1 centimeter, then 2, then 5 and 10. So that is how he has to arrange. So we have to know the size of each box. So that will be the second input, right? Now apply bubble sort logic and sort the boxes in ascending order. So using the logic, bubble sort logic, we have to sort them in ascending order and then display the size of boxes. 1, 2, 5, 10. So we displayed there. Similarly, here also display the size of boxes after sorting. So let us see this. So here we know that we have to have inputs, so we are taking I and j as indexes of the for loop, declare them as integers. N is the number of boxes and box of 20 is an array, so it can store 20 integers. Then we are taking temp, so that we have to sort them. So we need to sort swap two numbers, so we will take one temporary index, temporary number, sorry, temporary is used, temp is used to swap the two numbers. First input will be n, how many number of boxes to sort. So we need to sort n number of boxes. Next, we take input for the size of each box. So we enter the size. So starting from 0, we are storing each box size. So depending on the number, say we have n is given as 5, we have to enter 5 numbers. So those numbers are stored in the array box. So we are taking input for the array here. Next, so before sorting, we are simply printing that here first. So before sorting, what are the array elements, right? So whatever we have given, if we have given 10, 1, 2, 5, like in previous example, we will just give the same. That is, the same thing is printed so that we know after sorting what are the values. Now the sorting logic is here, right? So based on the values, so here we are storing it in box array. So previously we took the name as A, here it is box. So starting from I up to n minus 1, so that is the comparisons. So n minus 1 comparisons are there. Since we are starting from 0, we will give I less than n minus 1. Okay, if we had given 1 here, we have to give I less than equal to n minus 1. Since we start from 0, array element also starts from 0. So we start here I equal to 0. We have to give I less than n minus 1. And we also need to count the comparisons in each pass. So that is j. J starts from 0 up to n minus I minus 1. Right? So that is the number of comparisons in each pass. Now we compare the first element. J is 0. So box of j, is it greater than box of j plus 1? If the first element is greater than the second element, swap them. So we swap using a temporary variable. So this continues till the end of the box. So all the boxes are selected and then swapping happens if first number is greater than second number. And after that, we just display the sizes of the box after sorting, right? So this is the code for sorting. Let us see one tracing for this, right? So here I have taken the same logic, but just the variable names are different, right? So here, instead of box, the name of the array is array, right? So you can see array is the name, and instead of I and j, I've taken c and d, right? You can take any variable. So just for difference here, I've taken c and d, c instead of I, d instead of j. So we are comparing array of d with d plus 1, and swap is nothing but the temporary variable. So this code is for swapping. So this is the main logic for swapping, sorting using bubble sort. So let us see one tracing with an example so that it becomes very clear. So if we take an example of output, say we give bubble.c, we are entering 6 numbers, so 6 boxes, and each of them have this particular size. So we have given 6 numbers, integers, that is 58, 2, 14, 63, 18, and 6. So after sorting, we have to get the list in ascending order. So 2 is the smallest, then 6, then 14, then 18, next 58, and then 63. So this is our expected output. So let us see how does this work. So we saw the logic till now. So the main logic we have seen. So now how does it work? We can see with the help of an example. So the example is nothing but tracing. Note that tracing is very, very important to understand how it works. Please listen very attentively. So you can see here, array, we have given A, any name can be given. So there it was box, consider it is A here. And there are 6 boxes, right? So N is equal to 6. So we have taken input for N first, N is 6. And then we have taken input for the array elements. So the 6 array elements are as shown. So array starts from 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 up to 5 because n is 6, right? So there are 6 numbers which has to be sorted. So listen very carefully. So here we have taken C, right? C instead of I. So you can take anything. So C should be less than n minus 1. So this is for counting how many passes. So here first value we check. C should be less than n. N is 6. We have taken 6 numbers for sorting. So 6 minus 1. Yes, C is less than 5. So first initially, so we have to check is C less than 5. So initially C starts from 0. So if you take ij, you can consider here I and then d is j, right? So here the code is C and then d, right? C starts from 0. First pass 1, C value is 0. When C becomes 1, it will be pass 2, right? So for each value of C, it will be the next pass. So in this case, D starts from 0. So here we need to check. So okay, first number is A of D. Is it greater than A of D plus 1? So D is 0, D plus 1 will be 1. So A of 0 is 58. Is it greater than A of 1? Is it greater? 2. 58, is it greater than 2? Yes, true. So swap 58 and 2. So we are swapping the first two numbers. So 2 comes here and 58 comes to the second place. So we have swapped 2 and 58. All other numbers remain the same, right? So here all other numbers are the same. So next, D is incremented to 1. Right? So D is incremented to 1. Now 1 is checked. So A of D, is it greater than D plus 1? Note that the old array should not be checked. We cannot compare 2 and 14 because 2 is no longer in this position. It has changed to 58. Now we are working with this array. So don't consider the initial array now. Right? The most recent values only have to be considered. So we will forget this. Right? So for us, the array is this one now, right? So now, because we have swapped already, in this place, we have to check with the new values. So now we need to compare a of 1 with a of 2. Is 58 greater than 14, right? Is 58 greater than 14? Yes, true. So swap 58 and 14. 14 comes here, 58 goes here. So that is what we observe. 14 is coming here and 58 here. The rest three numbers remain the same. Now these old values are not considered. Now our currently array is this one, right? So we are checking the most recent value. Next, D becomes 2. So check D, A of D, is it greater than D plus 1? So that is, we check, is A of 2 greater than 3, right? A of 3 is 63. So is 58 greater than 63? No. So 58 is not greater than 63. So it does not enter into the if condition. There is no swapping. So it remains as it is. Now our array is as it is. Now D becomes 3. A of D is greater than D plus 1 is to be checked. A of 3, is it greater than A of 4? A of 3 is 63. Is it greater than A of 4? 18. 63 is greater than 18. Condition is true. So we have to swap 63 and 18. So 63 comes to fourth position. 18 comes to index 3. So when we see this, our array gets changed like this. So 63 has come here. 18 is here. So currently our array is this one. Right now, next, D increments to 4. We need to check A of D, is it greater than D plus 1? So A of D plus 1 will be A of 5. So check, is 63 greater than 6? Yes, true. So swap 63 and 6. So 63 comes to the last position. So when we swap them, 63 has come here and 6 has come here. Right. So now, next, when D gets incremented, so D will become 5. But what is the condition N minus I minus 1? So you remember the number of comparison. So instead of I here, we have C. So D has to be less than N minus C minus 1. So here N is 6. C is initially first pass 0 minus 1. That means D has to be less than 5. So after 4, if we increment, 5 less than 5, condition is false. So first pass will complete here. Please observe one thing. Out of all the numbers, the largest number has come to the last position. So that is in the correct position. So in the first pass, the largest number will come to the last position, right? So we are sending the largest bubble down. So that is how the container of bubbles will settle. Largest bubble comes down, smaller ones go up. So we had 63 somewhere in between when we entered the input, right? So when we entered, 63 was somewhere here. Whatever are the other elements, 63 is the largest. It comes to the last position at the end of pass 1. So pass 1, the largest has come to the last position. Now we will not touch that element, right? So we are going to only work on the other elements. So these 5 elements will be checked in next pass. So 63 is fixed to its position. Note that in pass 1, the largest number will be fixed to the last position. I hope this is clear till pass 1. Next, pass 2 means C becomes 0 plus 1, 1, right? So 1 is less than 5. So in this case, C has to be checked. So C is always checked. Till 4, we have to work on C, right? So if we have 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, right? So there are 5 passes for 6 elements. So C has to be less than 5. Let us continue. Pass 2. So what is pass 2? C was 0 in pass 1. So 0 plus 1. Pass 2, C becomes 0 plus 1, 1. Now again, note that D starts from 0. Very important. Right? So we will not continue from previous. D starts from the fresh value, 0. So D is to be checked with 0. So A of D, is it greater than A of D plus 1? So that means, is A of 0 greater than A of 1? So we are checking currently our array is this one. 63 is already fixed in first pass. So when we check here, A of 0 is 2. Is it greater than 14? A of 1 is 14. So 2 is not greater than 14. There is no swapping. Next, The array is the same. So now D becomes 1, right? D was 0. It becomes 1. So in this case, check A of 1. So now the array is same, right? So A of 1, is it greater than A of 2? Now what is A of 1? A of 1 is 14. So 14, is it greater than A of 2? That is 58. No, 14 is not greater than 58. So we don't swap. So when we observe 58 is the next largest, as per past 2, it has to come here, right? So now we have to compare 58. Let us see. When D becomes 2, A of 2 has to be compared with A of 3. Is A of 2 greater than A of 3? What is A of 2? A of 2 is 58. A of 2 is 58. A of 3 is 18. So is 58 greater than 18? Yes, condition is true. So 58 is greater than 18. So swap 58 and 18. 58 will come to third position. 18 comes to index 2. Right? 18 comes to index 2. 58 comes to third position. So we have swapped them. So now currently our array is this one. Right? So here D is 2. Next D becomes 3. So when D is 3, we have to compare. Is A of 3 greater than A of 4? So what is A of 3? 58. Is it greater than A of 4? 6. 58 greater than 6? Yes, condition is true. Swap 58 and 6. So when we swap, 58 comes to 4, index 4. 6 comes here. So 58 is in the second last position. 6 has come here. Now what is the condition for D? N minus C minus 1. So N is number of elements 6. In this second pass, C value is 1. So 6 minus 1 minus 1, D should be less than 4. So D was 3. When it becomes 4, 4 less than 4, condition will be false. So pass 2 completes here. What do we observe? Among all the other numbers, 58 was the largest. So it has come to the second last position. So in pass 1, 63 was fixed. In pass 2, we don't touch that, right? Then we fix 58. Pass 3, we will not touch 58 and 63. We will only compare these four numbers. I hope the concept is being clear now. So we are going to move the largest number to its position in each pass. So largest was 63. So it was put in the last place in pass 1. Next largest is 58. So it comes to its place, your second last position. Now in pass 3, similarly, the next largest number will come to its place. So on we will continue. Let us see what happens. So here, pass 2, C was 1, right? Now pass 3, C is incremented to 2. 2 is still less than 5. C less than n minus 1 is the condition to be checked. N minus 1 means 6 minus 1, 5. So 2 is less than 5. C less than n minus 1 was the condition. So since 2 is less than 5, we can continue. So now D again starts from 0. We have to compare A of D with A of D plus 1. So what is A of D? So A of 0 has to be compared with A of 1, right? 0 plus 1, 1. So A of 0 is 2. Compare with A of 1, 14. Is 2 greater than 14? Condition is false. Next, D becomes 1. Now compare A of 1 with A of 2. A of 1 is 14. Is it greater than 18, A of 2? No, 14 is not greater than 18. So condition is false. Next, D becomes 2. Compare A of 2, that is A of D, with D plus 1, A of 3. A of 2 is 18. Is it greater than A of 3? 6. 18 is greater than 6. Condition is true. So we have to swap 18 and 6. Right? Note that this is one swap here. 18 and 6 is swapped. So we get 18 to this position and 6 here. So now when we check again, pass 3, so D value becomes 3, but is it less? So what is N? N is 6 minus C value is 2 here, minus 1, 6 minus 2, 4, minus 1, 3. So D should be less than 3. So here after D equal to 2, next D becomes 3. 3 is not less than 3, so pass 3 will be completed. So inner loop completes here. So D will stop, right? So if we observe now, among the others, the third largest number has come to its place. Now we have fixed the third number. Past 1, 63 is fixed. Past 2, we fix 58. We don't touch them. Next largest number, 18, is fixed in place in past 3. Next, past 4, C has to increment. C is 2 here. C becomes 2 plus 1, 3. Right? Past 4, C becomes 3. 3 is still less than 4. Again, D starts from 0. So this is our current array. Right? In past 4, C becomes 3 and D starts from 0. Compare A of D, is it greater than D plus 1? So compare A of 0 and A of 1. So 2, is it greater than 14? Condition is false. Next, D becomes 1. Compare A of 1 with A of 2. A of 1 is 14. Is it greater than 6? Yes, true. So swap 14 and 6. So 14 comes to this position. So 14 comes here, 6 comes here. So among these three, 14 was the larger one, so it has come to place. So in past 4, the fourth number is fixed in place, right? So when we observe this, how till where we check the condition? So we have D equal to 1. So we have swapped these numbers, 14 and 6. So we got the array like this at the end of past 4. Now what is the condition for D? N minus C minus 1. N is 6. C is 3 in this pass. So 6 minus 3 minus 1. So D should be less than 2. Right? So when we increment D here from 1, it becomes 2. 2 less than 2 condition is false. So this loop completes. Right? So that is the end of pass 4. Fourth number is fixed in place. Even though we observe the sorted array, but still it will continue till the condition for C is true, right? So condition for C, only when it becomes false, then it will stop. So next, C gets incremented to 4. Past 5, C value becomes 4. So currently our array is this one. C is 4 now. Past 5, C becomes 4. So here 4 is still less than 5. We have the array like this. So first we have to compare. Again, D starts from 0. Compare if A of D greater than A of D plus 1. D is 0, D plus 1 will be 1. Compare A of 0, is it greater than A of 1? A of 0 is 2. Is it greater than 6, A of 1? So 2 is not greater than 6. There is no swapping, right? So 2 is not greater than 6. There is no swapping. Now, check for the condition. So every time we check, n minus c minus 1. N is 6, c is 4. 6 minus 4 minus 1. 6 minus 4, 2 minus 1 is 1. So D should be less than 1. So when it increments again 1, 1 is not less than 1. The loop will stop for D. Now again, when we increment C, it becomes 5. So 5 less than 5. C should be less than n minus 1, right? That is the condition. So 5 is not less than 5. So the pass will also stop. So this is our sorted array, right? So now it will display the sorted array 2, 6, 14, 18, 58, and 63. So this is the step-by-step tracing of bubble sort. So I hope this example is now clear. So here we have just a tabular representation. So this is again another way of representing the sorting. So here, let me see. We have taken the same example. So previous iteration. So instead of writing horizontally, in this table, it is written vertically. We can represent sorting like this also. So what we do first, we have the numbers written in vertical places. So this is our input array, right? So first value, first pass is given in this table, second pass here, and it continues. First pass, C equal to 0, and these are the values for D. So C is 0. We have seen the same tracing where D starts from 0. We are checking 58 and 2. So we see that 58 is greater than 2. So swap 58 and 2. All others are same. Next, D becomes 1. We have to swap A of 1 with 14, right? 58 is greater than 14. So swap 58 and 14. Next step, D becomes 3. we have to check 58 with 63. So 58 is not greater than 63. There is no swapping. Next, when D becomes 3, A of 3 is 63. 63 is compared with 18. Since it is greater, we swap 63 and 18. So 63 comes here, 18 goes here. Next, when D is 4, 63 is compared with 6. 63 is greater than 6, so it comes to the last position. So we have written this array vertically, right? 63 is the largest number. It comes to the last position. Note that it will not be changed. So largest number has come to the last position. So this is the end of pass 1. Now this array is given to the next pass. So first 2, then 14, then 58, then 18, then 6 and 63. We will not touch this last number. Now D starts from 0. Pass 2, C is 1. So when we compare first and second, it is 2 is not greater than 14. There is no swapping. Next, compare 14 with 58. 14 is not greater than 58. No swapping. Next, compare 58 with 18. 58 is greater than 18. So we swap 58 and 18. Next, compare 58 with 6. 58 is greater than 6, so we swap 58 with 6. Note that we don't compare anything with 63 because it is already in place. Now, second largest number has come to place, that is 58. This is the end of pass 2. So only the numbers are given here in this table, right? How we compare. That is the end of pass 2. Next, C becomes 2. So this is pass 3, then pass 4 and pass 5. Let us see how it works. So this is the array we got from the previous pass. So previous iteration, we have this array. So initially we compare 2 and 14. So 2, is it greater than 14? No, no comparison, no swapping. 14 is now compared with 18. So is 14 greater than 18? No, so we don't swap. Next, 18 is compared with 6. 18 is greater than 6, so swap 18 and 6. 18 comes here, 6 goes here, right? So now third largest number is in place in pass 3. We don't change the values of the other numbers. They are in place. Next, this is the array we send to the next iteration, right? In the next pass, C is incremented to 3, D starts from 0. So now compare first A of 0 and A of 1. That is 2 is compared with 14. 2 is not greater than 14. So the array remains the same. Next, compare 14 with 6. 14 is greater than 6. So swap them. So 14 comes here. So in pass 4, the fourth number is in place. Next, this array is then given to pass 5. C becomes 4. We check, is 2 greater than 6? No. So then we don't swap, and this is the sorted array. Okay, so this is the end of last pass, pass 5. Next, when C becomes 5, condition is false, so the sorting will not happen, right? So this is the sorted array. I hope this is clear. So please let me know if you have any doubts. Yes, dear students, any doubts?
Sir, come on.
Is this concept clear? Is this concept clear? Yes, Lohita, you were saying something?
No, ma'am.
Okay, any doubts? So here, you have to take example, right? Take an example and trace similarly. I will share the same file with you with the tracing. Please take one example for 5 numbers. Okay. Now I have done this for 6 numbers. You can take 5 numbers in the array and try to trace it. So in the first step, you have to check step by step. You take the values and try to trace it. So then you can know how it gets sorted. So basic here is the largest number will be put to its place in the first pass, second largest number in the second pass, and so on. We sort until we get the smallest number in the first place. So that will be how you can trace it. So that way you can understand it with one more example, right? So here I will send the same file to you through group, and also I'll put it in Edit. Okay, so now you can trace it similarly. So try and trace it, so then it will be even clear. If there are any doubts, please let me know. Yes. Okay, so now I had asked you all to go through the problems, and especially linear search also. I want to know if those concepts are clear. Rohita?
Yes, ma'am.
Any doubts till this concept?
No, ma'am.
And others? So you have the option, like you can unmute yourself also and ask if you have any doubts. Yes, so Rachana? Yeah, so you can send your messages through the chat box also. So then I will know if there is any doubt. Okay. So here we have seen the tracing, right? So this is using one example of six array elements, right? So in this case, we have sorted six numbers. So you can take an example and sort five numbers. Take any five random numbers and sort them. Trace it step by step. Okay. So when you trace it step by step, you can know how it exactly works with that example. Here, we can swap. We can check only two numbers at once. So we can perform only one swapping. So here we have a doubt. We cannot have two swapping taking place at a time. So we are swapping only once, right? So two swappings cannot take place at a time. So we are comparing two numbers, and those two numbers, if first number is greater than second, we can swap. I hope this doubt is clear. If you have any other doubts also, you can message through the chat box or ask your doubt. Okay, so there is only one swapping at a time which takes place. Then next step, when the value of D changes, so then we can swap the second time. We cannot put two conditions in the same place, because then we will not have the exact array, right? So before we swap, we will not know if that first value is greater than second or not. We need to get it step by step. So that is why a nested for loop is used. Okay. So here for this, it is very important to understand this logic. So I am displaying that part again, the main logic. So here, when you observe, there is a nested loop, right? So first loop is for C, then that is the outer loop where we are counting the number of passes. Inner loop is for D, where we count the number of comparisons. So here we have to give only one condition based on which we will sort it. Okay, so A of D is greater than D plus A of D plus 1, then swap. I hope this is clear. Now just if we have to sort in descending order, only the symbol changes. There is only one change. If we change this greater than symbol to less than, then the array gets sorted in a decreasing order. So descending order. So just change this symbol. So now you all execute this program, right? So then you can observe first with a greater than symbol, you execute it, then it will sort in ascending order. Next, just change this greater than symbol to less than. So if first number is less than the second number, swap them. So if we change this greater than to less than, it will sort the array in descending order. Okay, so once we sort in ascending order, next we will change this greater than symbol to less than, then it will sort the array in descending order. Note this change. So today you all execute this program with ascending order first and then change the greater than symbol here to less than. So then it will sort the array in descending order. So I hope this is clear. Is this clear? Yeah, Dhiren. Any doubts? Yeah. Please go through these concepts again. Is this clear? Dhiren, what is the particular doubt which you messaged? You can reply through the chat box also if okay. Yeah. Okay. Now I will display the full program also. Okay. So here. So here it is C and D, right? First, so let us see this again. So here, we have the first part. So here you just the variable names are different. You can use these variable names, or if it is confusing, I will display the lab sheet itself, right? So in the lab sheet which I have shared, the whole program is there. So here we have the program. Instead of C and D, it is IJ. Instead of A, it is box, right? So here, let us see the program. So first, we are declaring the variables I and J for the loop, looping variable. N is for the number of elements in the array. In this case, number of box, and box is the name of the array. In that example, we just took A. So it is box here. Temp is used for swapping. Now, number of boxes to sort, so that is taken as input. So this is n box to sort. Next, we are taking the input for array elements. So size of array elements. So size of each box is taken as input. So 0 to n. If there are 6 boxes, so 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So we take elements for array. So 6 numbers, 6 integers are taken as input. So in the next step, we are simply printing the same without sorting. So what are the boxes given as input? So size of boxes before sorting, whatever input we have given, same thing we print here. Okay, so till here we have just taken input for n and array, the numbers to be sorted. And next we are printing the numbers we have given as input, that is before sorting. So whatever numbers is given as input. Next part is the main logic for bubble sort. So this is the main logic for bubble sort. So here we have taken I and J. So in that example, C and D, any name can be taken. So I is starting from 0 up to n minus 1. That is to count the number of passes. So every time I increments. And J is to count the number of comparison. J starts from 0 up to n minus I minus 1. So J less than n minus I minus 1. So there we took D and C. So D less than n minus C minus 1 in the tracing, right? So condition for number of comparisons. Now we are comparing for J, is it greater than J plus 1? So box of J is the first number. J is 0. So 0th index. compare with first. So first and second number will be compared. If box of j greater than box of j plus 1, if a of 0 greater than a of 1, that is what we compare. If first number greater than second number, swap them. Swapping of box of j with j plus 1. So this continues for the inner pass until number of comparisons is checked. Next, when j value is larger than this n minus I minus 1, it comes out of the inner loop and I will increment to 1. That will be next pass. Again, pass 2, j starts from 0 and we check each element. And if first number greater than second number, swap them. This will continue till the end, until the last but one element. So in each pass, we are fixing the largest element and continue. So then we are checking I till n minus 1. So this executes till n minus 1 until all the values are sorted. This is the main logic for bubble sort. After sorting, we are printing the elements. The size of the box after sorting, we just print the array elements which are sorted. Is this fine? Okay. So here you all take input for 5 numbers. We just traced for 6 numbers, right? So in this example, we just traced for 6 numbers. So here, so we saw the tracing instead of ij, here it is c and d. I just told you that. So here, we have traced for 6 numbers, right? So if you take the sample output, it looks like this. So when you compile, so enter number of elements, 6. We entered the 6 numbers and then it will sort and print, right? So we have traced this for 6 numbers. All of you take any random numbers, take n equal to 5 and take 5 numbers. So here when we compare, we had 5 passes, right? So because 6 numbers, there are 5 passes. So if you have 5 numbers, number of passes will be n minus 1, right? So then you will have 4 passes. Take 5 numbers and try to trace it similarly, right? So starting from the first pass, right? So here compare first 2 numbers. If first number greater than second number, swap them. Similarly, 2 numbers at a time. We will swap, compare 2 numbers at a time and then swap. Okay. So if one number greater than second, then swap it. Then next check. So similarly, you try to trace it for 5 numbers so that you can let me know in the class, tomorrow's class, next class we have tomorrow. So trace it for any 5 numbers. Okay. So take n equal to 5 and trace it similarly. Use this logic and let me know. So you can trace it and send it to me, right? So if you have any doubts, you can message. So all of you, please message your name and number, ID number. Send in your name and ID number. Okay. So this is the tracing. Similarly, you trace for n equal to 6. Take any 5 numbers and complete this tracing. Trace it till we get the sorted array. Okay, so lab sheet 3 is shared already. You have this code with you. You can find it in EDITCH also, or it is there in the class WhatsApp group also. Okay, so using this, you can trace, right? So with 5 numbers, you trace this. So in case you have any doubts based on output, you just take a screenshot and send it to me. Right? So you can send the screenshot to me and then I will reply. So if in case you got some error, you're not getting output, so you can send it to me. So then I can find out whatever error screen you have and also the program which you have typed, so that your doubts can be cleared. So then I will know if there is any mistake or if what is the problem, so I can find out. Okay. So I see again the number of participants is less. So here this is one complaint from other faculty also. Please attend all the classes regularly and inform your friends also to attend all the online classes regularly. Okay. Yeah. Next, we have seen this sorting. All of these are for one dimensional array. In next class, we will discuss about two dimensional array also, something similar to matrix, right? So let us see that next. So for today, we have seen linear search, just again I revised, and that watch that video also if you haven't. If you have watched, very good. Execute these programs. If any doubts while executing, please take that screenshot and send it to me. Send your program also, okay, so that I can help you out for execution. And then we discussed the sorting technique, bubble sort technique. We discussed one example first to understand the logic. So with just numbers, we saw how it gets sorted, right? Swapping in each case and how many passes and each comparisons we checked to see how we can sort the array using bubble sort. So then we saw the logic, right? So the logic for the bubble sort we just saw, right? So the nested loop wherein we swap based on the condition. And then we discussed problem 6 with the problem statement for bubble sort. So we have to read number of elements and the elements of the array, which is size of the box, apply bubble sort logic and sort them, and then display the sorted array, which has the sorted size of boxes. So this program we just discussed, wherein we take input for n and the array. We just print the unsorted array first, and then we have the logic for sorting, right? So the logic for bubble sort, and then we have the sorted array. Once we apply this, the array gets sorted, and after that we print the sorted array. So this is what we discussed in today's class. Okay, please go through the lab sheet programs and execute. If you have any doubts, you can ask, you can send in your message, I will reply to them. Okay. Yeah, thank you.